It's that time again. Let's see what's in the vintage toy box. And today on Vintage Toy Box, we're doing another Lego build. So I'm joined once again by my lovely hubby. Thank you for joining me for this. Let's see what we're going to build. So today's build is going to be Star Wars. And I believe this is the Imperial Trooper Battle Pack, which we're going to build today.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what the little two-legged robot thing is called. I know it's quite a big part of the Imperial forces in Star Wars. Maybe someone out there actually knows what it's called, because I can't remember. But it looks pretty cool anyway.
Okay then, let's get on with the build.
Cool. Okay, let's take a look firstly at the box. As you can see, it's, I think, 6 to 12 years of age. Obviously, Star Wars.
Hold up bits so people can see.
And you can see the little Disney there, just to let you know that Disney now owns Star Wars. I like the Star Wars movies. I wouldn't say I'm like a fanatical fan, though, but I've never built... Well, I have built some Star Wars Lego before, but not something like this, so... Not big like this. The little Star Wars mini ships I've built before. Anyway, so let's see if we can open the box. I take it we don't need a 500 watt chainsaw to get into it.
Definitely
do
not.
Perhaps we do.
There's some of these boxes you definitely do.
Can anybody tell me how to get into this thing? All right. Looks like we're going to have to be violent.
Just rip it.
I don't like ripping it.
We ain't got time for that.
Right, so we come with this, and there's the instructions as normal. We put the box away, so we can.
You can still see the Star Wars
thing. As usual, there's a number of different pieces. Okay, that's how the men fit together.
I think they're pretty. Okay,
so I wanted to show you this. Can you see it? Yep. Now the little men have little guns, which are these things. If you can see, and that looks like this fits into there, and you press something, and it actually shoots the thing, which is interesting.
Really? You don't normally get Lego figs that do that.
Yeah.
Or not.
Oh yeah, no, you've got to add. I haven't added the trigger to it. I want to show you guys this because I find it. There it is.
I find it very interesting.
Very
too.
Interesting. we never had this sort of thing. Right. Okay, so the little what stick goes in there, and then I think, my fingers are very big, okay, it's just check this, so you make sure you can show people, and bang, quite powerful. Yeah. So there we are. So I'm going to pass the men and the gun bits over to Rose, and she can build them and then show you what they look like in the end. So just to show, right, you take this thing, you see it's like an arrow shape, okay?
Yes.
And you literally point the arrow to the back of the gun.
Okay.
Right.
You've just thrown it away.
Goes in here, slide in like that, and you just press it till it clicks.
Okay. Well, I bought them in first.
Like that.
I'm missing a body. There's the body.
Right. So, that's, as I said, the first page, as you saw.
Legs.
Which is just the men. I think we've got some white stormtroopers and the black, I think it was an Imperial Guard, I think. Anyway, so, number one looks quite simple.
So I'll do a quick show. I've got the
Imperial Guard.
Imperial Guard, the black one. We've got two of them.
Yeah.
In the set. And then you got two little, trying to hold this up. I'm sitting next to the camera, so it's a bit hard, but two white guys. Now I've got to just put their guns together again.
Normal stormtroopers, I think.
So now you're building the two-legged thing.
Yeah. Well, maybe we should have Googled what it actually is, but it's quite nice to see if you guys know what it is, I suppose.
Yes. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Leave a comment down below and tell us what this two-legged robot thing is.
So this was actually a Christmas present to me from some good friends who know that I like Lego, and also as I, over Christmas, was recovering from a hip operation, it was supposed to give me something to do, but I thought I'm still recovering, so I'm doing it now, but it's cool.
Never had Star Wars. Have you ever had Star Wars Lego before?
Not when I was a kid. We didn't have that sort of stuff. There was nothing specific. You know, they didn't do specific things for films. They didn't have the, I don't know if it's copyright or the rights to do it when I was a child. Right. It was either castle Lego or pirate Lego or city Lego or space Lego.
I meant right recently.
Recently?
With the stuff you buy and sell. We buy and sell.
Well, probably about a year ago, we bought those little mini spaceships. I think we had the Millennium Falcon and
oh yes, I remember those.
One of the Imperial fighters. They were in little mini packs.
Shame we didn't do a video with them.
Yeah, I sold them, I think.
Yes, you did. I mean, I suppose they have to be the colours they are for the thing you're building.
Oh, yeah.
I know Lego likes the bright colours, but it really wouldn't look good to have a Star Wars Lego set in all different bright colours. I think certain people would object.
Well, I think when you get the rights to the movie, you've got to keep to a certain... you know, you've got to be realistic and true as possible to the movie. Which I find in the Lego, some of the sets, like there's a big one for the Millennium Falcon, look really real, you know, really good. And even they have the interiors of these things, and it's quite amazing, I think, how the design came about.
How did it come about?
Well, I don't know how they design it now. I suppose they put in what they want to build into a computer, probably, and it comes out and says, well, these are the sort of bricks you need. I don't know. We should find out, actually.
It'd be quite interesting to find out how they used to do it before CGI-ing computers, you know, the original Star Wars stuff.
A lot of these bits they're using these days, when I was younger, they would be considered like technique Lego, especially these bits with joints and stuff.
Was that more of a specialised type of Lego?
Yeah, I mean, with technique Lego, some of them even had little motors in them and they would turn wheels and things like that. And you got cars and cranes and, you know, that sort of thing. It was for older children, basically, even teenagers, because you could put motors in and all sorts of stuff. They still do it, but they've incorporated some of the technique pieces into these Lego bits now to create movement. The old Lego, there wasn't that much movement in it. And they've animated it, I suppose you could say. This is the foot. What's a foot? About 6 inches. Was it 12? I don't know. What is a foot?
Thank you.
So there you are, all done.
Mm.
It was quite a nice little set, and there's a few little bits left.
Okay, good. And that's our Lego build complete. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please rate, comment, subscribe down below. It really helps us out. And yeah, a question that might divide the audience, but I'm going to ask it anyway. Are you a Warrior or a Trekkie? Star Wars fan or a Star Trek fan? Let me know in the comments below.
And also
go ahead.
And also, if you know the name of this machine or and the four-legged one, you can remind us about it. Thanks.
Yes, please do. Anyway, from me.
And me.
Till next time in our next Lego build together. Bye.
See you then.